Yeah, I'm Heather Mitches.
Okay, and Mission?
Mitches.
Mitches,
okay. Like matches.
Oh, okay.
With an I.
Would you spell it?
M-I-T-C-H. Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. And you were just saying that you're not a American, but you're originally from England. And where's your citizenship now?
I have both English and Canadian.
Okay, so dual citizenship. And you did reside in Canada mm-hmm. previously.
Mm-hmm.
And
my children are Canadian.
Okay. And they still live in Canada?
Mm-hmm. Well, two of them do.
Uh-huh. Well, how long have you been here?
I've been here a year and a half full time, and I spent 2 winters before that.
And what prompted you to reside? I mean, do you reside here now as your primary residence?
At the moment, yeah.
Okay. And you're married or single?
Yeah, single.
Okay. And you have children?
3.
And what are their ages?
39, 37, 34.
Okay. So they're grown up and independent of you and all of that.
Fortunately.
So are you working or retired?
Retired.
Do you do any activities here that involve work or anything? Or are you just really retired?
Yeah.
Enjoying life. And well, why have you chosen to live overseas, and especially and specifically, why here in Mexico?
Well, I can't stand Canadian winter.
Uh-huh.
Not in Ontario, anyway. And I went all through Central America looking at each country and decided Mexico was the most convenient, probably the most easiest to live in,
and
the nearest to Canada in terms of going back to visit my children.
Mm-hmm. And so what do you think are some of the challenges that you faced since moving here?
Well, some of the challenges or some of my concerns, which would
both.
You rather? Okay, challenges. Probably, I do a lot of handicrafts. I paint, sew, embroider, do everything like that. And there just isn't, I can't wake up one morning and think, oh, I want to do so and so, go out and buy the materials.
Mm-hmm.
So that is a handicap for me. Concerns, the crime, the corrupt police, and the government keep changing their regulations for immigrants.
How do you cope with that?
Well, I'm coping by following what happens at the moment. With the crime, I don't go out after dark. I go out early in the morning to shop, etc.,
mm-hmm.
and get back as quickly as I can. Only because my doctor, her brother and father were kidnapped and murdered
ransom.
Another doctor's wife and her friend were kidnapped and murdered from the parking lot in Walmart. So I've decided the earlier in the morning I go out and get back, the better it is.
Yeah, can you tell me some more about that? Is that a fairly common occurrence?
Yeah. Kidnapping for ransom. And we've had a few incidences. Lady down the street is a housekeeper for a house down there. Her son was kidnapped by the drug gang and murdered. There were a few. And they've threatened to kidnap 150 people since they arrested the 5 policemen who were in cahoots with the drug gang.
And that's a local event happening?
Yeah.
I mean, it's not off somewhere else in Mexico, but
no,
right
this
here.
Is local. They were walking along the Malecon, the one from here,
mm-hmm.
carrying his baby and little 3-year-old with him. Just had to drop it on the pavement, and off they went and killed him.
So
it's quite bad here, and the police are corrupt.
Mm-hmm. Do they put you under pressure to pay bribes and?
Yeah. I've had one incident.
Well, that's a unique challenge. I haven't encountered, that before. It doesn't seem to be a big problem in Ecuador. But apparently
I did a stint in Ecuador teaching English. It seemed to be okay. But then I was way out in the country on a farm.
So is that impacting at this point your decision as to whether or not to stay here? Are you considering leaving? And where would you go? What would you do?
I will probably either go back to Europe, because I used to live in Switzerland, used to work in Switzerland, or to the west coast in Vancouver, around there, Victoria or Vancouver.
So aside from these horrendous challenges and threats.
Yeah, I mean, I love the climate.
Okay, I was going to ask.
And I like the Mexicans. They're very sweet. Apart from all this other stuff going on. And the food here is wonderful, the fruit and fresh fruit and vegetables. You can't beat them, they're just marvelous. But I don't know.
So how imminent is the possibility that you'd be leaving?
I'm thinking of renting my place for the next winter and going to Europe. So, just for the winter, just to see whether I really want to leave here or not.
Can you share a story that illustrates some of the best things about your experience here?
The best things? Well, I have wonderful neighbors. I like my neighbors very much. An experience. Can't really think of anything.
Do you have a lot of interaction with an expat community here?
No, I don't.
Okay, so you have Mexican friends?
I avoid it because there's too much gossip goes on.
Really?
Yeah. I can't be bothered.
Like small town, I guess.
Yeah.
Did you have any orientation or preparation before you came here? And could you go through the review again, how you made the transition? You came down first, you visited, visited a few times?
No, my neighbors in Canada have a house here.
Okay.
And when they heard about my trip all through Central America, well, why would you go down there? Why don't you go here? And you can rent our house for the winter, et cetera, which is, that's how I originally found Ahahik.
Because
I probably would never have heard of it.
Did you rent here or did you buy?
No, I bought.
Okay, so you have residence here. And did you have any other preparation? Do you speak Spanish or did you have any cross-cultural training?
I did Spanish for 4 years. I used to work for the UN, so I speak French fluently. And Spanish I can read and write, but speaking sometimes I use the wrong words. Not enough practice.
Yeah, I know. I know after having lived in several countries and knowing a little bit of a lot of languages, I end up speaking, Arabic words when I'm meant to use.
Right, I know. If I can't think of the Spanish, I use Italian or French.
Yeah, right, whatever works. Yeah,
but they usually understand me.
What other, can you share any of the stories about other people, other foreigners, living here, and what kind of experiences that they've had? We started off with some pretty heavy duty ones. Are there others that?
Some Canadians just moved in down there, and they got robbed last Wednesday. Broken into. But I have neighbors across here. They're Canadian. They've been here 12, 13, maybe 14 years now. They probably could give you some really nice stories about Mexico, because they've done a bit of traveling around.
But you think that things are getting worse rather than better here, or?
Well, having not lived here before, I don't know. I mean, somebody who's been here 13 years we'd be better placed, or even and to judge that. Well, in fact, they say it is getting... I saw a headline in one of the Mexican newspapers recently, last week, that said the delinquency here has increased drastically in the last few weeks.
Is that because there's no, lack of employment or education, or what do you think contributes to that?
I was wondering if it was the summer holidays and some of the teenagers have come up home from the States back home, you know, to Mexico. And I don't know. I mean, there were two Mexican boys who came up 2 years ago or last year, and they murdered somebody. They were washing cars in the Walmart parking lot. But part of it is...
Was it for robbery or for...
Yeah, they went to rob somebody at their house. Somebody they knew. But I think some of it's political. Because the previous president really tried to clean things up. So the drug gangs retaliated. What's going to happen with this one, I don't know.
Do you think that if... drugs were decriminalized in the States, that it would have a huge impact on the Mexican cartels?
That's a huge question.
No.
Yeah. I mean, you wonder. I don't know. I've listened to arguments on both sides, and I don't know if I'm for or against. Theoretically, it should improve things because to decriminalize them. Because then they'd be cheaper and available, and perhaps it would help. I don't know.
I live in Mendocino County in California, and what we're experiencing is that there are large numbers of people who have been controlled by the gangs, who are set up there, and whose families are being essentially held hostage here, and they have to go up there and work for them. And grow out in the forest, grow pot and all that kind of thing. And so it's pretty bad for them, and not good for us.
Well, do you think that it should be decriminalized?
Myself, personally, yes.
But I kind of lean towards that, but whenever I discuss it with anyone, they're so anti it that I don't know.
It's such huge money in the drug business that. Well, that's what's driving, and keeps the war on drugs alive and all that. But my own, it's not my interview, but my own personal, knowledge of it is that there are many, many law enforcement people who are pro-decriminalization, and the money that goes into the war on drugs is also a big problem, because if they stop that, there'd be thousands of police out of work because they're funded and their departments run on that money. So, and then of course there's a lot of pressure from overseas countries saying if you decriminalize, how are we going to fight it?
Well, of course, Canada wanted to, and the U.S. really put their foot down.
We have several states.
It stopped.
Okay. So, just a couple more questions, and what advice would you have for people who are considering moving to Mexico?
Rent first.
Rent first, and what
and
about...
Then rent for a couple of years and then decide.
What about orientations, or is it a great advantage to speak the language, or...?
Oh, I think they should have a minimum of Spanish. Instead of just going and saying, pointing, and,
Yeah, talking louder.
Yeah.
So is there anything else you'd like to comment on related to your experience of living abroad, or any other stories that you'd like to share?
No, I mean, I've always lived in Europe, so mm-hmm. Other than several years in Canada, but basically my life was in Europe.
Mm-hmm. And how did that compare to like living here?
Well, I was certainly a lot less nervous.
Uh-huh.
I mean, if you thought the police would act and do anything,
yeah,
you'd feel a lot happier about the situation. But mm-hmm. A friend of mine had her car stolen, and she saw it downtown and went, "You've got the police." And they looked at it and said, "Oh no, that's the drug cartel. We're not interfering with that."
Really?
Yeah.
So they're threatened too.
Yeah.
And under.
And every time I drive to Guadalajara, I think, and get back safely, I'm quite relieved. You know.
You think there's any? Is there any solution to this? This situation?
Not in the immediate future. No. The cartels are too much money, too much influence.
Yeah. Well, thanks very much for sharing your stories. I didn't realize, that such things were happening so immediately here.
Oh, you didn't?
No.
Oh,
I mean, I knew, I read about it in different places in Mexico, but I didn't realize it was so immediately close to.
The
living situation here.
One of the articles in the newspaper last week was, they are going to stop publishing all these negative things. This is
publicity.
Prieto, whatever his name mm-hmm. is. He's going to clamp down on advertising all these bad things that are happening.
That's going to help a lot, huh?
There are people that are producing underground newspapers and things and publishing all these details.
Uh-huh.
But they fear for their life.
Oh, I bet.
You know?
Yeah. Well, the brutality that has been reported is pretty awful.
Well, that's the other thing. The underlying cruelty to the Mexicans, I can't understand it, because they're so sweet.
Mm-hmm.
And yet when you hear crimes, they really are brutal. I mean, they just cut people's heads off.
Yeah. Well, by the dozens, it sounds like.
Yeah, when they kidnapped a bunch of kids here a couple of years ago, I mean, they cut their heads off, and they were still alive. Just, and I don't understand where that brutality comes from, unless it's from the ancient Spanish practices of, they came in and murdered and, brutalized.
Made that part of the brutalization, the tradition.
Made it part of the culture.
Yeah. So not a very close to the surface part. But, Well, it's really interesting. Well, thanks again, Heather. And
I'm sorry I couldn't be more
That was very interesting.
Positive thing
about Mexico.
Is the medical system.
Uh-huh.
The doctors are fantastic.
Really?
Yeah. And very nice. You don't feel they're doing it just for the money. They're not over-pressured. You get immediate interviews, appointments. It doesn't matter what you want, MRI or whatever. You could pretty well choose your time to have it done. And the results are back immediately, which is such a contrast to Canada. Whereas,
Is it a socialist system, a socialized medical system here? Or?
Yeah, no, it's private.
Uh-huh.
There is a socialized medicine for some people.
Is there insurance available at low cost? Or?
Yeah, there's insurance. I actually don't need it because I have it with the UN.
Uh-huh.
But there is a system for people to join.
I see.
And the doctors have trained in the States a lot of the times.
Yeah, we're just talking about the Mexican medical system as compared to the Canadian system?
Yeah, in Canada, if my son had back surgery and then his back went again in the January, he couldn't work or anything, and it was 6 months before he could get an MRI appointment.
That's terrible.
He had to go to Buffalo and have it done privately.
It's interesting. I've heard really mixed stories. I have a friend who unfortunately died, but he had a bone cancer, and he got terrific treatment. He was a Canadian citizen, and he got terrific treatment and the state-of-the-art stuff in Canada.
Yeah, I think if it's an emergency, a real emergency, like a heart attack, and you can get into the system, it's good.
Okay.
But if it's anything, I don't know, it just depends which doctor you see too. I mean, his doctor tried to get him in and called two specialists. Neither of them bothered to reply.
Well, and so how does it work here? Do you just call, pick the phone up and call a doctor, or do you make appointments ahead of time?
Yeah, you can just call and you can see the doctor usually the same day, maximum the next day, if there are any tests to be done. It's arranged immediately. You either go the same day or the next day. Blood tests and things, they give you the results, so you can take them into the doctor. In Canada, you don't have any control over that. Here, I can see a specialist. I don't need a GP to recommend me, to refer me. In Canada, you can't go to a specialist without a referral.
Interesting.
And as I said, the doctors here are pretty well trained in, a lot of the time, they've done some training, and especially the specialists
in the States.
And the other thing here, the doctors, after they finish their training, they have to do a year out in the country in some tiny village before they can open a practice. So, you know, they're getting fairly general.
It's a real hands-on general experience. Very good. All right, well, thanks very much, Heather. I appreciate it. You taking your time and sharing your stories.
In Ecuador, I was in hospital.
Yeah, we're just talking about the Mexican medical system as compared to the Canadian system.
Yeah, in Canada, if my son had back surgery and then his back went again in the January, he couldn't work or anything, and it was 6 months before he could get an MRI appointment.
That's terrible.
He had to go to Buffalo and have it done privately.
It's interesting. I've heard really mixed stories. I have a friend who unfortunately died, but he had a bone cancer, and he got terrific treatment. He was a Canadian citizen, and he got terrific treatment and the state-of-the-art stuff in Canada.
Yeah, I think if it's an emergency, a real emergency, like a heart attack, and you can get into the system, it's good.
Okay.
But if it's anything, I don't know, it just depends which doctor you see too. I mean, his doctor tried to get him in and called two specialists. Neither of them bothered to reply.
Well, and so how does it work here? Do you just call, pick the phone up and call a doctor, or do you make appointments ahead of time?
Yeah, you can just call and you can see the doctor usually the same day, maximum the next day, if there are any tests to be done. It's arranged immediately. You either go the same day or the next day. Blood tests and things, they give you the results, so you can take them into the doctor. In Canada, you don't have any control over that. Here, I can see a specialist. I don't need a GP to recommend me, to refer me. In Canada, you can't go to a specialist without a referral.
Interesting.
And as I said, the doctors here are pretty well trained in, a lot of the time, they've done some training, and especially the specialists
in the States.
And the other thing here, the doctors, after they finish their training, they have to do a year out in the country in some tiny village before they can open a practice. So, you know, they're getting fairly general.
It's a real hands-on general experience. Very good. All right, well, thanks very much, Heather. I appreciate it. You're taking your time and sharing your stories.
In Ecuador, I was in hospital.
Yeah, we're just talking about the Mexican medical system as compared to the Canadian system?
Yeah, in Canada, if my son had back surgery and then his back went again in the January, he couldn't work or anything, and it was 6 months before he could get an MRI appointment.
That's terrible.
He had to go to Buffalo and have it done privately.
It's interesting. I've heard really mixed stories. I have a friend who unfortunately died, but he had a bone cancer, and he got terrific treatment. He was a Canadian citizen, and he got terrific treatment and the state-of-the-art stuff in Canada.
Yeah, I think if it's an emergency, a real emergency, like a heart attack, and you can get into the system, it's good.
Okay.
But if it's anything, I don't know, it just depends which doctor you see too. I mean, his doctor tried to get him in and called two specialists. Neither of them bothered to reply.
Wow. And so how does it work here? Do you just call, pick the phone up and call a doctor, or do you make appointments ahead of time?
Yeah, you can just call and you can see the doctor usually the same day, maximum the next day, if there are any tests to be done. It's arranged immediately. You either go the same day or the next day. Blood tests and things, they give you the results, so you can take them into the doctor. In Canada, you don't have any control over that. Here, I can see a specialist. I don't need a GP to recommend me, to refer me. In Canada, you can't go to a specialist without a referral.
Interesting.
And as I said, the doctors here are pretty well trained in, a lot of the time, they've done some training, and especially the specialists
in the States.
And the other thing here, the doctors, after they finish their training, they have to do a year out in the country in some tiny village before they can open a practice. So, you know, they're getting fairly general.
It's a real hands-on general experience. Yeah, very good. All right, well, thanks very much, Heather. I appreciate it. You taking the time and sharing your stories.
In Ecuador, I was in hospital.
Yeah, we're just talking about the Mexican medical system as compared to the Canadian system.
Yeah, in Canada, if my son had back surgery and then his back went again in the January, he couldn't work or anything, and it was 6 months before he could get an MRI appointment.
That's terrible.
He had to go to Buffalo and have it done privately.
It's interesting. I've heard really mixed stories. I have a friend who unfortunately died, but he had a bone cancer, and he got terrific treatment. He was a Canadian citizen, and he got terrific treatment and the state-of-the-art stuff in Canada.
Yeah, I think if it's an emergency, a real emergency, like a heart attack, and you can get into the system, it's good.
Okay.
But if it's anything, I don't know, it just depends which doctor.